It can't be.
No.
Welcome back to another Doctor Who series review. Today I'm going to be reviewing series 4. If you're interested in watching any of the other reviews, click up in the corner now. I'm not even going to be able to say how many more I've done, but there's a lot. So we're starting at the best place to start, which is Voyage of the Damned. So, Voyage of the Damned. I prefer the 2005 theme. The more I heard this new 2008 theme tune, the more I got to like it, but I still prefer the 2005 one. I think the setting was really interesting, it being set on the Titanic in space. It's pretty much exactly the same plot as The Robots of Death, which is one of my favourite stories, so this kind of feels like a bit of a rip-off of that. I love the Doctor's speech. I'm not even going to bother saying it because I can't even remember it, but it's really, really good.
I'm the Doctor. I'm a Time Lord. I'm from the planet Gallifrey in the constellation of Casterbarus. I'm 903 years old and I'm the man who's going to save your lives and all 6 billion people on the planet below.
I think it was really silly how close the Titanic was to hitting Buckingham Palace. I mean, the story's alright, but I mean, nothing special. Like I said, it's more a rip-off of The Robots of Death, if anything. Partners in Crime. I think the whole story is quite underrated in general, but it is quite silly still. I think it was really funny seeing the Doctor meet again after so many times just missing each other. And I thought that scene where they were having the conversation through the window was really cool, even though at one point I did get lost in what they were saying. I think Wilf is lovely, obviously we'll get to him later on as well. There's a lot of convenient moments in Partners in Crime, I think. And Rose just had to be at the end. I don't know why they did that. I know it was meant to build up her return at the end of the series, but it wasn't really needed. The return would have been absolutely fine if they didn't reference her until turn left. The Fires of Pompeii. I love the reference right at the start to the Great Fire of Rome, which obviously I think the Doctor caused it in the Romans. I'm not quite sure, I can't really remember. But there is a lot of references to previous stories in this series. And I think the reason behind that is because it's the 45th anniversary. I know it's not an amazing anniversary, but it was the first one since 2005. I think towards the end it was really emotional. I think a lot of that came down to the fact that the acting was so good and the all-round, the performances of every single member of cast was spot on. It was absolutely phenomenal. And the whole story is really good. It's really underrated, I think. Planet of the Ood. It's pretty shit. It's nice seeing the Ood again. There's a reference to Sensorites and there's also a reference to the Ood 2 parter in Series 2. I'm not sure why that security guard goes to the Doctor with that big claw. I don't know why he didn't just start to set his men on him. It would have probably been easier. I think the CGI when that bloke transformed into the Ood was really good. But I think overall this story is quite forgettable in general. The Sontaran Stratagem / the Poison Sky. It was nice seeing Martha back. There's great references to the Doctor's unit days back in the 70s or 80s. I really don't like the Doctor's attitude towards guns and soldiers. John Pertwee was always fine with that. He didn't really seem like he gave a shit. I know the Time War has happened since, but I feel like it's just stupid and I feel like it's just having a go at people when it doesn't need to have a go at them. I think the Sontarans were handled really badly. I really don't like the short design. If they weren't so short, I'd see past it a little bit. I think they were only made short, because they were never short in the classic series, I don't think. For some reason, they just made them short in this. And I think it was for that one line where that soldier said something about getting out of school early or something. I don't mind the fact that they're blue. I preferred the design of the old ones in general. But the blue design I can see past. But they came across like such cowards, which obviously the Sontarans aren't, so that annoyed me. I think they really missed an opportunity to bring Bessie back. I feel like Luke is just as annoying as Adric, and he seems like he could be Adric's little brother or something. I think Wilf, again, is lovely in this, and we get to see more... As we see more and more of Wilf, I think you start to love him more and more. And he's definitely one of the best things to have come out of Series 4, in my opinion. I hate how the Doctor said in The Christmas Invasion that he doesn't give second chances. Yet when he goes up onto the Sontaran ship, he gave him the chance. And I don't understand why he did that. It's so out of character for the 10th Doctor. And while everyone seems to think David Tennant is the best Doctor, I just feel like he's different every story. And this is a perfect example of that, I think. Overall, the story isn't as bad as I remember. It's definitely not the best Sontaran story, but it was alright. The Doctor's daughter, it was awful. I think it was very convenient that Jenny just happened to be really good at gymnastics. And right at the end, when after Jenny got shot and died, or didn't die, and the Doctor picked up that gun and he goes to shoot that guy in the face, but he doesn't pull the trigger, and he just says, "I never would." It would have been so good, and I would have had... I would have just loved this story just for that. But he didn't, obviously. And I think the ending, when Jenny got brought back to life, it was stupid, and that was Moffat's idea. I know that, and I know he didn't write this story, but I know that was his idea to do that. And that's such a Moffat thing to do, and I fucking hate it. I don't know why he can't just rest characters as they are. It would have been so much more effective if she just died. The Unicorn and the Wasp. I think this is a really underrated story. It's quite forgettable, I think, but it's still quite fun. I love the setting. Obviously, there was references to previous stories like The Unquiet Dead. I think the Vespa form looked really good. The CGI has definitely improved this series. I like how it solves the mystery of Agatha Christie. I like it when Doctor Who solves mysteries like that. But the whole story is essentially Doctor Who does Cluedo. Silence in the Library / Forest of the Dead. It does what Stephen Moffat was always known for back in the RTD era, where he makes children afraid of such normal things. Obviously, in this case, it's shadows. And obviously, in the previous stories, you had the gas masks, you had the clocks, and you had statues, and making you afraid to blink and stuff. I think River was a really interesting character at this point. This was before she got annoying. I think the tone was very dark, to the point where when I was little, when I first watched this, when it aired, I was terrified, especially when that woman, I've forgotten her name, the young woman has like the disfigured face, and it doesn't look that great looking back now, but it was terrifying when I was little. I think River's death was really emotional. They handled that really, really well. It's just a shame they ended up bringing her back in, sort of in her timeline after these events. The ending, like I said, was really Moffat-y, where they bring all these characters back, but in a CGI world, in a way. But overall, I think the whole story was really good, and it was passable. Midnight. This is a fantastic story. I love how we never actually see the creature. I think it's a very cheap way for them to do it, but it's really effective. Guy was really creepy. Just the actress that played her did it very well. There's a great performance from her. It really does a great job of showing how vulnerable the Doctor can be. And the whole group in that were just knobheads. You just hate the lot of them. Other than maybe that teenager that made me laugh a couple of times, actually. Most of them were shitheads. Turn left. I think it's a really interesting idea, where it shows off how small decisions have big consequences. It really shows that off quite well. I'm not sure why they had to make out that Donna is the most important woman in the universe. The Doctor's not stupid. When he drowned the Rathnos, he would have known to go. He's not four. He doesn't need someone to tell him, "Oh, we need to go now because we're going to drown." I think it gets really dark when they start to take people who aren't British to labour camps. And Bernard Cribbins' performance, when he says it's happening again, it's really impactful, I think. Is that a word, impactful? I feel like it really, really worked. But I feel like the ending was so exaggerated. Why the hell did everything say Bad Wolf? They never actually explained that. The Stolen Earth, Journey's End. This could have been so much better, I think. I think it was really nice to see Torchwood and the Sarah Jane Adventures into the main show. I'm not sure if it was 100% necessary, if it was more just them just saying, oh yeah, there's these other shows. If you want to watch them, these shows are on as well. So, sort of a way to advertise those, the other two spin-offs. Davros is back. He's probably one of the saving graces of this story. The bees being aliens was very silly and unnecessary. The whole thing of, yes, I know who you are, to Harriet Jones, got so annoying. It was meant to be funny, but I just wanted one of the Daleks to come out the screen and shoot me. Talking about Daleks shooting people, why did the Dalek choose to shoot the Doctor instead of Rose? I know he's got beef with the Doctor, but if he shot Rose, everything would have been perfect in Doctor Who. I think the cliffhanger is really exciting, and this is the one time where I've watched the story live and I've genuinely been thinking, what is actually going to happen this time? There were so many plot holes throughout this story. Why would the Daleks have on their ship controls to blow up every Dalek, spin every Dalek around in a circle, and why the hell did the Doctor run out the TARDIS and offer to save Davros? He's a cunt, just leave him, mate. I feel like they really missed a trick when Jack and Martha were walking off, and Jack says something to Martha like, I'm not sure about UNIT these days. Maybe there's something else you could be doing. I feel like that was really hinting at Martha getting into Torchwood and her possibly replacing Owen. And then obviously Mickey runs out and he's a computer geek, so he could be replacing Tosh. And that could have worked really well, but they just missed a trick, I think. Bernard Cribbins as acting really just wants to make a tear come out your eyes in a way. But I think the whole story in general is just so overrated, and it gets a lot of praise just because I think there's so much fan service. But yeah, so that's the series in a nutshell. Thank you for watching this review. Follow all my social medias. Subscribe to my channel. Like the video. Comment below. And I'll see you later.